is from IIT Delhi, and he's a remarkable man himself, but we know him best as Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal's brother. And besides being such an accomplished person, he is an amazing storyteller. So those of you who have read Arun's story in The Brave, Mr. Mukesh Khetrapal was the one who told me the stories from Arun's childhood, from his growing up years, and he made Arun come alive for me as an author. So I'm very grateful to him for the interviews, the time that he gave us. And you're so fortunate that today he's going to be telling us stories from Arun's life, and I'm looking forward to it as much as all of you are. So we'll get on with it. I'll just briefly introduce you to our three panelists, the compares for the morning. Shriyanka, who's a rifle shooter and an MBA. And we have Aman. Aman is an army aspirant. And we have the bearded, handsome Lalit, who is in the private sector. He is also one of our volunteers. And Mr. Khetrapal, I'd like to tell you that we have about 67 people joining us this morning. Many more wanted to talk to you, but most of these are young people and they're big fans of Arun Khetrapal, and it's completely from the heart. So I'm sure you will also enjoy the interaction. Thank you so much. Over to Shriyanka.
Okay, a very good morning and welcome to all of you. And I know we're all super excited about this session, sir. Jaise hi hum logo ne, and so this week, after concluding Kargil conversations, which we were doing prior to this, we thought let's start with another series of conversations, that is 1971 conversation. And who better to start this storyline, who other than talking about the legend himself? So that we got a lot of good response when we gave it out that we want to have a session with you. There were so many youngsters who wanted to join us. So it's an honor for us. Hum sab bahut excited hain aapse sunne ke liye unke bare mein. And everyone knows Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal. He is the youngest recipient of Paramveer Chakra. And we all have heard a lot about his bravery, how he refused to come out of his tank even in the most dire situation. So to start the session, I would be showing you all a video which has been prepared by Palash and Harsh. So we'll start with that.
No, sir. I will not abandon my tank. My gun is still working, and I will get these bastards. Such was the bravado of one of India's finest officers, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal, who was just 6 months in the service when he went into war with his head held high. 14th October 1950 marked the day when yet another brave heart joined the Khetrapal's clan. They hailed a glorious legacy of producing warriors. Arun Khetrapal was son to Brigadier M.L. Khetrapal and Miss Maheshwari Khetrapal. An ace kid at academics and sports alike, at the Lawrence School, Sanawar, he was destined for success. He joined the National Defense Academy in 1967. And in his final term became the squadron cadet captain from Foxtrot Squadron. He went on to join the Indian Military Academy and thereafter was commissioned into the 17th Pune Horse on 13th June 1971. He was undergoing the young officer's course at Ahmednagar when the Indo-Pak War of 1971 broke out. He was immediately called back to serve in his unit in what was later known as the Battle of Basantar. The 17th Pune Horse was assigned to the command of the 47th Infantry Brigade. A joint operation was tasked to establish a bridgehead across the river Basantar. The Indian troops observed alarming enemy activity. The 17th Pune decided to push through the minefield. On 16 December 1971, A Squadron, of which 2nd Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal was a part of, was called upon to respond promptly in an aid the B squadron. Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal launched a ferocious counterattack on the Pakistani Patan tanks. Outnumbered, yet undeterred by the enemy tanks, he charged on with a daring attack and single-handedly destroyed five enemy tanks with his Famagusta JX-202 before being hit by an enemy shell. Living to the highest traditions of the forge, he switched off his transmitter whose signals were those of backing off and went on to further neutralize two more enemy tanks before attaining martyrdom. This was a foundation victory for the Indian Army during the 71 war. Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal, sir, is nothing less than a legend who inspires us through his legacy. With courage and skill way beyond his age, the legendary 21-year-old is the heartbeat for all of us youngsters who aspire to be even half the man he was. It is an honor for us to have known the story of India's hero, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetrapal.
I hope you enjoyed the video, sir, and I hope every one of you liked it. So this was made by our team members, Palash and Harsh. Harsh, are you there with us today? I think both of them are busy with some work. So Palash had said he'll not be able to join us, but thank you so much. And aaiye ab hum shuru karte hain questions ke saath. So a lot of people gave in a lot of questions. The first question that we'll start with, I would like to call Lalit. Lalit? Lalit, unmute kijiyega.
Hello, I'm audible now?
Yeah.
Hello, sir. Good morning, sir.
Morning, Lalit. Good morning.
Sir, we would like to know some of the childhood memories of Arun sir and you.
Surely, yeah. Okay, actually, Arun was 1 year older to me. And we hail from a family which has been, you know, part of the military establishment for years. My grandfather was fought in Africa against Rommel's, you know, the Nazi forces in World War I. My father was an army officer, you know, a brigadier, and he fought World War II against the Japanese. And again in 1965, actually, he was in that same area where Arun fought that battle of Basantar. So from our very childhood, it was not unusual that our grandfather would tell us stories of the war. We would go to sleep and there was one particular story that he told us again and again and again, you know, of his time. And that became a favorite story. So actually, you know, the military tradition was part of our family, and it was destined that since my father was an army officer, that one of his children would join the armed forces and the other would become an engineer, because he was from the Corps of Engineers. The Corps of Engineers, as you might well know, are tasked with the removal of mines, laying of bridges, you know, in the war front area. So since my father was from the Corps of Engineers, so he kind of destined that one son will become the engineer and one will become the army officer. And guess what? My brother was more intelligent than I. So it was destined that, you know, I would join the armed forces and Arun would become the engineer. But fate of this destiny kind of changed things around. It so happened that Arun became... He joined the armed forces and I ended up being the engineer. In fact, it was a rude shock to us because soon after completing our Indian school certificate exam, we used to have an ISC kind of an exam in those days. Arun was asked to appear for the IIT, and as a fallback chance, because IIT is a little difficult exam, he was told to appear for the NDA exam. The result of the NDA, you know, exam came out a little later, and the result of the IIT exam came out a little earlier. And, you know, can you believe that Arun actually qualified for the IIT?
Oh, wow. I didn't know that. Wow.
Did you know that, Rajna?
Nay, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so actually what happened was that, you know, so we were all very happy and we were congratulating him for a, you know, great job. And IIT was prestigious, and that, you know, and my father's, you know, wish of him becoming the engineer was, you know, about to get, you know, fulfilled. But within a few days, the NDA result appeared. And of course, you know, he'd qualified for the NDA. Now, Arun's heart was torn because he never ever wanted to become an engineer. Right from our very childhood, it wasn't unusual that if my father's uniform was, you know, being readied for the morning next day, we would end up wearing his peak cap, wearing his belt, taking his soti, you know, and of course, spoiling his uniform in the process. Like all young children, I'm sure, you know, you also emulate your parents. And the vardi is a strong attraction to young people. So we would end up wearing that vardi, and my you know, brother would end up, you know, marching and saluting, you know, much like he would see, you know, the troops that my father would, you know, go out to. He would, given an opportunity, he would go and attend every single parade, or if wherever possible, try and accompany my father on a visit, you know, or you know, to the troops. So therefore, Arun was very, very keen right from the beginning. I wasn't so keen. I mean, I did, but I wasn't the kind of sort that would actually want to go out, you know, early in the morning to witness a parade, or to go, you know, to a trip somewhere in some difficult terrain area. But Arun was the first one to volunteer. So for many days, we had a strong, discussion, and there were a lot of undercurrents on the dining table. Because my brother would tell my mother that, Mama, I don't want to join IIT. And why don't you talk to Papa? So on the dining table, after much cajoling, one day my mother, you know, picked it on herself to say, ki, Arun, IIT nahi jana chahta. So my father looked at him and says, what? You know? So somehow Arun picked up the courage and saying, yes, Papa, I don't want to join the IIT. I want to join the armed forces. So my father tried to reason with him, saying that, beta, you know, I mean, IIT is quite a prestigious institute and you must join the IIT. And this discussion went on, and my father would have, you know, wouldn't listen to him at all. But the conversation, the whole week, every day in the evening, there was silence on the dining table, and the only conversation was this. Till finally my father realized that his son, his heart was to go to the NDA, and he finally told him, ki, okay, beta, you take your decision. Whatever you do, I will support you. And that's how Arun ended up going to the IIT. And suddenly I was told that, you know, now you have to become the engineer. So that became the, you know, tough thing for me to do. But that's the way Arun was. You know, we were close. There was a year, we were a year apart. I was a spoiled youngster, because I would fight with my brother, you know, for every little thing. Because, you know, he being 1 year older, I would get his second-hand clothes. I would get his, you know, chota cycle. I would get his, you know, hand-me-downs. And so I always thought that my brother was the favorite one of the family, and I was the, you know, the other one. So I would fight with him for everything. But my brother was very patient. You know, whenever, even if he had two glasses of milk and the same milk was there, I'd say, no, I want that glass of milk. I don't want this one. Something like that. You know, so that's this thing. But Arun was, you know, a very, very considerate elder brother, very responsible elder brother. And I knew that, you know, so long as I could do whatever mischief I wanted to, and I had an elder brother to, you know, support me. So those are some of the memories of my childhood. There are, of course, more stories.
Yes.
Okay, I must tell you one more story. You know, tells you about Arun. Years later, I told you, you know, Rasnaji told you I went to IIT. I went to IIT Delhi. And there was a dhaba outside IIT Delhi. Rasnaji, I don't know if I told you this.
I remember. Yes.
You remember that? Okay, so I'm going to tell you that story. Yes. So, since we used to study late into the night, and the war had just happened in 71, in December 71, and sometime in 72, we used to study in the late at night, and we used to go to this dhaba in the evening to eat aloo parathas and, you know, have coffee at night, you know, late in the evening after our studies. I'm sure many of you in your college must be having a favorite canteen. So here you are. So we went there, and since 71 had just happened, you know, the news about Arun getting, you know, dying in battle and about his bravery was coming out in the newspaper. So my friends were asking me, you know, what happened and, you know, can you tell us more? So about four or five of us, we were having our coffee and I was trying to tell them about, you know, about what happened in the war. And there was a young man who was, you know, the owner of the dhaba. And he was serving us these parathas and the coffee. And he was, you know, silently hearing our conversation. So we finished our parathas and I went up to pay the bill, you know, or my share of the bill, you know, to the dhaba wala. And he told me, ki saab, hum aapse paisa nahi lenge. So I told him, you know, that's not fair. You know, you run a dhaba and I think, you know, wo baat dusri hai ki mere bhai, you know, I thought because, you know, in recognition of the fact that, you know, my bravery that I've talked about, he says, no, I can't take it from you. I said, why? He says, I know your brother. I said, my God, how do you know my brother? Yeah? You know? So he asked me that, did you ever live in Shillong? And my parents, my father was posted in a non-family station, and my brother and I and my mother, we used to live in Shillong. And we went to a school over there called St. Edmund's School. It's a sister school of St. Columba's School. Later on, of course, we went to a boarding school in Sna'a. But at that point in time, I must have been 6 years old and Arun must have been about 7 years old. So I said, yes. We used to live in Shillong. So, but I said, how do you know? He says, even I used to live in Shillong. I said, really? He said, yes. So he asked me then, did you and your brother study in St. Edmund School? I said, yes. Now this was getting very, very curious. I said, you know, I mean, how is this person, a dhaba owner, sitting in Delhi, know anything about, you know, my family, in which school I went to and my background? So he says, ki sab, main aapke bhai ko kabhi bhool nahi sakta. So I said, kyun, kya hua? And actually now I'll share another part. I'll come back to this part a little later. My father, you know, used to come from his non-family location to Shillong. And he took us shopping one day in Shillong. And he bought us two very nice woolen pullovers. Sweaters, similar as a cold, it's a hill station. And they were very soft wool and very nice. And so on a cold winter day, Arun and I, when we going to school, we wore our new, you know, cardigans. You know, we wanted to show it to our friends. And we went to school and in the evening, when we came back, I had my cardigan. But my brother's cardigan was not there. So my mother was very angry with him. Ki beta, you know how expensive this cardigan is and your father bought it for you. And, you know, How, where have you left it? So my brother said, Nini, was school mein padha hai, I will bring it tomorrow. So next morning, jab my brother was going to school, she reminded him, ki, Arun, don't forget, bring that cardigan. So, mama, I'll bring the cardigan. He came back next evening, next day from school. We both came back and the cardigan wasn't there. So my mother scolded him, you know, how can you be so careless? You know, I told you, you know, where is that cardigan? And you've forgotten it again. This story went on every day for the next 2-3 days, but there was no cardigan. You know? And so Arun got, you know, quite a mouthful from my mother saying that, you know, you're a very careless boy and this, that, the other, you don't value money and this, that, whatever. Now, I come back to the story of this Dhabawala. He says that on a cold winter morning, my father was the peon and I was playing and I had a cold and Arun gave me a cardigan.
Wow.
Such a small world, sir, and how things come back.
Yeah, what a fascinating story that is.
So that tells you the character of what Arun was.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
He was very caring. Okay, so I hope, Lalit, I've been able to give you some insights of who Arun was.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's beautiful. Sir, now I would like to call upon Kiran Bisht. She has written a poem which she wants to dedicate to Arun sir. Kiran, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah. Hi, Kiran.
Good afternoon to everyone. I'm Kiran Bisht from Jaipur, BSc first year student. And I have written a poem which I want to dedicate to Arun sir. So it was like that. Ki, Sone ki is dharti ne kai ratan hai boye. सोने की इस धरती ने कई रतन है बोए और उनके बलिदानों में कई रतन है खोए और उनके बलिदानों में कई रतन है खोए इस देश में गंगा बहती है इस देश में गंगा बहती है ये तो हम सबने सुना है लेकिन ये कहती क्या है कभी किसी ने ये पूछा है कि भूल गए हम सारे बलिदान कि भूल गए हम सारे बलिदान जो हमारे जाबाजों ने दिए थे जो हमारे जाबाजों ने दिए थे खो बैठे हैं हम अपना ईमान जिंदगी की दौड़ जीतने में जिंदगी की दौड़ जीतने में छुट्टी है माना वीरों के नाम पर खबर है किसी को उनके काम पर याद करें हम उनकी कोशिश एकजुट भारत की वरना समझ लो दोस्तों वीर गति गई व्यर्थ गई कुर्बानी थैंक यू सर
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Very nice. Okay, so next I'd like to call Aman. Aman wants to ask you something, sir. Hello, good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, Aman. Sir, we all want to know about some funny incident or some funny story that whenever you remember it, it just leaves a smile on your face, something like that. So please. Okay.
Okay, I don't know if it's a funny incident, but it's certainly an unusual incident that I will tell you about. Okay. This instance is when Arun joined the regiment. Okay, I was told about this incident later on. He joined the regiment called the Pune Horse. The Pune Horse is a very decorated regiment. It is perhaps, you know, in the armed forces, the most highly decorated regiment of the entire armed forces. So if you go to their, you know, mess, you find they have trophies and it's a 175-year-old regiment. They have fought wars and battles, you know, across the world. And, you know, collected various kinds of trophies, you know, for each battle that they fought. So if you go to that regiment, it is steeped with history. Now, when a youngster joins the regiment, there is a ceremony there. And in that ceremony, It's called the dining in ceremony, I'm told. Okay. Where they're all dressed in their, you know, what they call the blue petrol, which is their formal, you know, party wear. And it's a long table, about, you know, 30, 40 people can sit around that long table. And during the dining in ceremony, they raise a toast to the, you know, historical events that have, you know, the regiment has negotiated with success and bravery. So they raise a toast, and so somebody starts by raising a toast, say, I raise a toast to, you know, this battle in this thing, and this is what happened. And everyone says, yeah, yeah, and they have a little drink. You know, bottoms up. Yeah. So this kind of, you know, toast raising, and since there are many battles that they won, they raise many toasts. Yeah. So you can imagine how many bottoms up would have happened, you know. And obviously, you know, with a little bit of liquor like that, you know, you can get quite high with a few bottoms up. So they kept doing this. And finally, then it's given to the young man and says, okay, now it's your turn, Arun, to raise a toast. So Arun raised his glass, and I say, I raise a toast to the winner of the first Paramvir Chakra, Colonel Tarapur. Now, I don't know if you know, but Colonel Tarapur was also awarded the Paramvir Chakra. He's also from the Pune Horse. In 1965 battle, he died in battle while leading the Pune Horse against you know, the Pakistan Armed Forces again. And his silver statue is there in that, you know, mess. And so he raised the stage to him, and everyone says, yeah, you know. So everyone raised a toast and says, I clapped and says, yes, of course. But just then, I don't know if Arun had one toast too many. He says, no, but I've got another second toast to raise. So everyone's wondering now, what is he going to say? This young man has come and he's going to say, I'm going to say. So he says, he raises his glass again and he says, I raise the second toast to the second Paramvir Chakra winner for Pune Horse, Second Lieutenant Arun Khetripal. Can you imagine? Now, this event had actually happened, you know, a good 6 months before the war actually started. Wow. So it was certainly unusual. And I was told about this incident by, you know, General Ajay Singh. That time he was Major Ajay Singh. He was the, you know, adjutant in that in the regiment. And General Ajay then later on went on to become, he was the lieutenant governor of Assam, you know, a very well-known entity in his own right. But here was an incident which was, you know, I mean, people laughed at it, saying that, you know, maybe this young man has had one too many. But maybe it was a kind of bhavishwani of what actually happened. So this is one event that kind of really, you know, has stuck in my mind. It's unusual, you know, perhaps at that moment funny, in retrospect, you know, I don't know, you know, I mean, what if you call it funny or not. Yeah. Okay, so so that's another story that certainly sticks in my mind.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing this with us. It's I know it's actually such a different story, like you're saying, when we, at that moment, probably funny, but then in retrospect, it has another level to it, another dimension to the whole thing. Next, I'd like to call, we have with us Arihant, who has written a poem for, which is dedicated to sir again. Arihant, are you with us?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
So good afternoon, sir. This is the regarding Arun Khetripal. जला वो सिंह चाल जब आ गया था भूचाल कैसे करतब दिखाए उसने कमाल के
अरिहंत
तो इसलिए वहां बहुत ज्यादा तरीके से रिलेशन
या मैम आई एम सो सॉरी टू म्यूट समबडी
ओके मैम ओके चला वो सिंह चाल जब आ गया था भूचाल, कैसे करतब दिखाए उसने कमाल के, तारीफ क्या करूं मैं वो है बेमिसाल। दुश्मन से लोहा लेने को डटा हुआ था रण में वीर, हिला ना पाया पथ से उसको कई आए अकलबीर। एक एक टूट पड़े सब उस पर, गिरते गए मुंह के बल, हैरान थी दुनिया जब अरुण ने मचा दी हलचल। सात पैटर्न मार कर रुक गया फामागस्ट, आठवां बनकर आया काल, आठवें को मार कर शहीद हो गया लाल। तू भी हिंद का कुमार है, निस्वार्थ देशभक्ति अगर है तुझमें, तुझमें भी अरुण क्षेत्रपाल है।
वाह, वाओ, वेल डन,
ब्यूटीफुल।
यू नो बट यू कैप्चर्ड द एसेंस सो वेल। एक चीज मैं आपसे कहना चाहूंगा
जी सर,
कि अरुण को भी ना एक किस्म से एक एक इनर ऐसी स्ट्रेंथ थी कि यू नो आपको जैसे आपने कहा ना जटा हुआ था है ना उस अपने स्थल पे, कि अगर वो एक चीज को मन में कर लेते थे ना, तो जैसे सलमान खान ने भी कहा है ना कि क्या मैं फिर हाँ क्या भगवान भगवान के भी नहीं सुनता,
मैं एक बार कमिटमेंट कर दूं तो फिर मैं भगवान के भी नहीं सुनता।
That's right. So, अरुण का भी कुछ ऐसे ही मतलब एक कैरेक्टर था, एंड हो सकता है कि वो कैरेक्टर उस समय टेस्ट किया गया कि अगर उन्होंने कुछ चीज अपने मन में गांठ बांध के सोच ली है, तो फिर वो यू नो कोई उनको वहां से टस से मस उनकी यू नो सोच को हिला नहीं पाते। तो आपने जो है अपने पोएम में इसका वर्णन किया है, तो यू नो उसका भी यू नो इसी से ताल्लुक है, तो इसलिए मैंने कहा कि मैं आपसे भी शेयर करूं। वेल डन,
थैंक यू सर,
थैंक यू अरिहान, थैंक यू सर। नेक्स्ट आईड लाइक टू कॉल अर्चन, अर्चन वांट्स टू आस्क यू समथिंग। अर्चन आर यू देयर?
यस मैम।
या
सर, कैन यू प्लीज टेल अबाउट द इंसिडेंट व्हेन ब्रिगेडियर Khetrapal met Brigadier Nazir when he visited Lahore.
Okay. ऐसा है कि you know my father we are refugees from you know Pakistan. When in 1947 my parents belonged to a place called Sargodha. Sargodha to लगभग यू नो कई साल बाद एट द एज अबाउट 79 माय फादर टोल्ड मी कि आई वांट टू गो एंड विजिट माय होम टाउन, मैं सरगोधा जाना चाहता हूं। तो यू नो ही वुड ही सेड दिस, दो तीन दफा उन्होंने कहा, तो हम भी कहते कि पापा कहाँ जाओगे, पाकिस्तान है ना यू नो, and you're not growing any younger, you know, you're 79. पर हमने उनको दो तीन दफा टालने की कोशिश करी, पर वो मतलब जो है वो अपने मतलब जो है ये थॉट उनके मन में था, और वो बार बार यू नो ये अंदर से बात आती कि नहीं मैं जाना चाहता हूँ, मैं जाना चाहता हूँ। एक दिन शाम को वो यहाँ पे दिल्ली में एक वो उनको You know, ताश खेलने का शौक था, ब्रिज खेलते थे, you know, he was a good bridge player, my father. तो एक क्लब है यहाँ पे दिल्ली जिम खाना क्लब, तो शाम को वहां से लौट आए, लौट से क्लब से लौट के आए, and he told me कि you know कि next week I'm going to Pakistan. तो हमने कहा कि पापा ये कहाँ हो, क्या हो गया, मतलब suddenly you know decided to go to Pakistan. कैसे जाओगे, कैसे you know? He said नहीं नहीं ऐसा है कि My father also studied in Government College Lahore. Government College Lahore के पढ़े हुए थे, और Government College Lahore का annual day कुछ हो रहा था, और वहां से you know वो सब old boys को एक न्योता भेजते हैं, और मेरे साथ में मेरे father के साथ में वो club में इनके चार पांच लोग और भी थे जो Government कॉलेज लाहौर के पढ़े हुए थे, तो उन्होंने उनको भी वो इनविटेशन मिला, तो उन्होंने सब डिसाइड किया कि क्यों नहीं हम सब लोग इकट्ठे मतलब गए लाहौर चलते। तो इन्होंने फिर तो हमने भी किया, अच्छा चलो आप लोग इकट्ठे जा रहे हो तो फिर यू नो कुछ तो है यू नो देखने में मतलब है। नहीं नहीं हमारे पास वहां पे है, हमारे स्वागत के लिए हमको इन्विटेशन आई, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है। तो हमने कहा आप रहोगे कहा? इसे नहीं, हमें क्या होता है कि ओल्ड बॉयज को वो किसी ना किसी यू नो के घर पे रुकवा देते, जो ओल्ड बॉयज का मतलब जो है वहां पे उसके घर में उनको रुकवा देते। तो हमने कहा चलो ये भी अच्छा कि आप होटल में नहीं रुकोगे, किसी के घर में रुके तो आपका की वो देखभाल करने के लिए कोई होगा। तो श्योर इनफ नेक्स्ट वीक आया, उन्होंने यू नो फ्लाइट पकड़ी और वहां से लाहौर पहुंचे, और लाहौर पे उन्होंने एक सज्जन थे वहां पे कोई ब्रिगेडियर साहब थे, तो उनके घर पे यू नो मेरे फादर को रुकवाया। तो फंक्शन हुआ, उन्होंने फंक्शन अटेंड किया, फिर मेरे फादर ने कहा कि बेटा मुझे यू नो वहां पे सरगोधा जाना, सरगोधा फ्रॉम लाहौर इज अबाउट 100 किलोमीटर्स, मुझे थोड़ा सा टैक्सी कर दीजिए। एक वीडियो कैमरा जो होता है ना पुराने जमाने में शादी वाला, वो वीडियो कैमरा जो एक वीडियो बन जाए तो मैं एक टेप बना के अपने यू नो बच्चों के लिए ले जाना चाहूंगा। एक एक कैमरा वाल मैन को भी साथ में कर दीजिए। तो उसने जो मेरे फादर ने कहा कि हाँ अंकल हो जाएगा, कि आपके पास ये यू नो टैक्सी भी हो गई और आपके यहाँ मतलब जो है ये वीडियो कैमरा मैन भी आ जाएगा साथ में। So my father went to Sargodha in the morning and came back in the evening. And next day he had to take his flight back to Delhi. So शाम को जब ये डिनर पे बैठे थे, तो ये ब्रिगेडियर साहब ने कहा कि ब्रिगेडियर साहब, you know, he was much junior to my father was much older than him. He said कि ब्रिगेडियर साहब मैं आपसे कुछ कहना चाहता हूँ। मैंने कहा हाँ बेटा क्या कहना चाहते हो? He says कि 1971 war में, you know, I was also part of that battle. He says, हाँ अच्छा? He says, तो my father asked him कि कौन से corps से? I'm from 13 Lancers. अब 13 Lancers की कहानी आपको ये पता होना चाहिए कि partition के time पे Pune House को दो टुकड़ों में बांट दिया गया था। आधी टुकड़ी यहाँ पे इंडिया रह गई और आधी टुकड़ी लाहौर चली गई, और लाहौर पे जाके पाकिस्तान चली गई, उसका नाम 13 लांसर्स हो गया। तो पूना हॉर्स का ये एक किस्म से हिस्टोरिकली अंक जो था वो 13 लांसर्स के रूप में वो पाकिस्तान में, और 1971 में 13 लांसर्स और पूना हॉर्स का आमने सामने लड़ाई हुई थी जिसमें मेरे भाई यू नो शहीद हुए थे। तो मेरे फादर ने पूछा कि आप कौन से कोर से? इसमें 13 लांसर्स थे। So my father said, oh, yeah, my son was also in that battle and he's from Pune House. So this brigadier turned around and says, I know your son. So my father says, how do you know my son? He says, no. He says, sir, I was part of 13 Lancers in Pune House and we fought face to face. And the other thing that he told my father was that ki brigadier sahab aapke jaisa bahut bahadur beta nahi hota to ho sakta hai ki the history of that war uska naksha kuch aur hota kyunki us war mein ye ek shakhs the ya ये एक रेजिमेंट थी जिनके होने की वजह से, उनके कारनामे के वजह से ये बैटल का रूप बदल गया। He says because I was the commanding officer of 13 Lancers, मेरा नाम ब्रिगेडियर नासर है और तब मैं मेजर नासर होता था, एंड आई वॉज द कमांडिंग ऑफिसर ऑफ 13 Lancers जिसके अगेंस्ट दैट बैटल दैट योर ब्रदर जिसमें आपके बेटे शामिल थे हमने आमना सामना किया था, और मैं आपको यह कहना चाहता हूं कि एक्चुअली अंत में केवल मेरा टैंक जिसका मैं कमांडिंग ऑफिसर था और अरुण का टैंक का आमना सामना, हम लोग मुश्किल से 100 गज की दूरी में आमने सामने थे, और आपके बेटे ने जो गोला चलाया वो मेरे टैंक को हिट करा, पर
I am lucky that I'm alive because I bailed out of the tank and I went and hid under the tank. पर जो मेरे टैंक से जो गोला जिससे फायर हुआ था उससे आपके बेटे शहीद हुए हैं.
So that's such an amazing story. So Mr. Khetrapal, what was your father's reaction to that?
No, so what happened was that, you know, my father came back the next morning from Pakistan and wo bade chup chup rehne lage. He didn't tell us a thing. So humne socha ki shayad thak gaye hain, you know, 4-5 din bahar rahe hain. तो हमने कहा कि पापा आप थक गए हो, आप आराम करो, ये है वो है, यू नो. बट वो बड़े चुपचाप रहने लगे और कुछ मतलब उन्होंने कुछ हमसे कुछ एक मतलब इसका ही डिडंट टेल अस अ थिंग. आफ्टर अबाउट 6 or 7 डेज देयर वाज अ बुक बीइंग रिलीज्ड ऑन परमवीर चक्र at Ashoka Hotel, and the gentleman invited my father ki aapke bete ke upar bhi ek chapter likha hua hai, to aap please aaiye, ye book release ho rahi hai. My father went to that function and jaise typically, you know, press hote hain, you know, kisi press reporter ne mere father se baat puchi aur ye jo hadsa hua tha Pakistan ka jo hua tha वो उन्होंने इस प्रेस रिपोर्टर को बता दिया. और मुझे इंडिया टुडे में एक रिपोर्ट आई और मुझे जब मैंने इंडिया टुडे में रिपोर्ट पढ़ी तब मुझे पता लगा कि ये ऐसा मतलब ऐसा हुआ था. तो हमने कहा कि पापा आपने मुझे हमें बताया क्यों नहीं. He says, बेटा मैं आपको, you know, मैं आपको क्या बोलता, व्हाट कुड आई हैव सेड टू यू. सो दैट वॉज द एक्चुअली इंसिडेंट, you know, as it happened.
The story.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir, for sharing that with us. I think we all were transported there. It's a very emotional story. Next, I'd like to call Savni. Savni has written a poem for sir, and then she also has a question. So Savni, please unmute yourself.
Okay. Jain sir, I'm Savni, an 11th grader from Nashik, and I've written few lines for sir, which I would like to dedicate. Bahare fir bhi aayengi, घटाएं फिर भी बरसेंगी, कल सावन में तुम्हें हमारी याद जरूर आएगी. कई सावन आए और बीत गए, लाए हर्ष मेरे मन में, मेरा सावन बीत चुका है, ना रहेंगे प्राण मेरे तन में. कल रवि फिर से आएगा, धरासंग अपना वादा निभाएगा, कल तारे फिर से उमड़ेंगे, अंबर फिर से गाएगा. पर माँ तू रोना नहीं, पापा आप आंसू बहाना नहीं, भैया तुम गम में खो जाना नहीं, मैं लौट कर आऊंगा इसी जमीन पे, इसी मिट्टी पे जहाँ बीता था मेरा बचपन. मेरी यादें संजोए रखना, अपने दिलों में मुझे हमेशा जिंदा रखना. ए वतन, तेरे लिए मैं बार बार मर मिटने को हूँ तैयार. बहारें फिर भी आएंगी, घटाएं फिर भी बरसेंगी, कल सावन में तुम्हें हमारी याद जरूर आएगी. जय हिंद.
Well,
Sabrina, you can ask your question.
Yes, sir. So I wanted to ask that when was the last conversation you had with Arun sir, and what was his last words or what was his message?
Okay. No, actually, you know, my last meeting with Arun was that he was returning from something called the YO's course, Young Officers course in Ahmednagar. वो course attend करने गए थे और वो course जल्द उनको terminate करना पड़ा था और वो train से, ये नासिक के पास में है और आप भी शायद नासिक से हैं, you know?
Right.
तो ये नासिक के पास से, तो नासिक से अहमदनगर actually पड़ता है, अहमदनगर से ही वापस आ रहे थे और रास्ते में for 2 घंटे के लिए उनकी कनेक्टिंग ट्रेन आगे को थी, तो हम 2 घंटे के लिए पहले मिले. तो ये लगभग हमको यू नो आप समझिए कि अबाउट 20 डेज before, that was the last time I met him. And my parents met him. But, we kept getting his, we used to get his letters. और उस टाइम मतलब जो है वो मतलब ईमेल नहीं होता था तो इस सेल में डाक से लेटर आती थी और क्योंकि वो वॉर फ्रंट था तो कई लेटर्स यू नो लेट से पहुंचती थी और हमारे पास कई लेटर्स तो तब मिली यू नो तब भी मिली उनके ये हादसे होने के बाद भी जब हमें पता लग गया था कि वो अभी भी नहीं है यू नो द लेटर्स we received about two letters even after he had passed away, you know, and he was telling us that saying that, you know, how, you know, everything was great and he was, you know, looking forward to reaching Lahore because, you know, Arun was very fond of playing a game of golf called, you know, golf. तो ने कहा कि मैं लाहौर गोल्फ कोर्स पे मैं गोल्फ खेल के आऊंगा एंड दैट इज व्हाट ही रोट इन द लेटर यू नो सो दैट वाज द लास्ट यू नो आईड से कम्युनिकेशन दैट आई हैड विद हिम
थैंक यू फॉर शेयरिंग दैट विद अस सर नेक्स्ट वी हैव महेंद्र प्रताप मौर्य ही इज गोइंग टू आस्क यू समथिंग महेंद्र अनम्यूट करिए
यस गुड आफ्टरनून सर My question is, what is your message to the youth of today, sir?
I think that's a wonderful question.
Sorry, sir?
My message, I'm saying that's a very wonderful question. Bahut badhiya question.
Thank you, sir.
See, my message to the youth is, you know, we all live and die and go away. And people forget us.
Yes, sir.
We are so busy, you know, trying to do things for ourselves. हमको और कमाना है, हमको अच्छी कार खरीदनी है, हमको अच्छा घर खरीदना है, हमको अच्छा वेल्थ लेना है. But these are selfish things. My message to you is that, you know, life is, we are all here for a purpose. And we all have a larger purpose.
Yes, sir.
हमको मत हम क्यों आए हैं कि खा पी के यू नो मर जाएं चले जाएं what a waste you are young people you should leave a legacy for yourselves legacy तब बनती है जब आप कोई चीज किसी और के लिए करें एक cause होना चाहिए जिसके लिए आप जी रहे हैं चाहे जो भी कॉज हो इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट यू हैव टू गो टू वॉर एंड डाई हो सकता है कि आप जिस फील्ड में हैं आप इंजीनियर हैं आप डॉक्टर हैं आप लॉयर हैं पर ऐसा नाम करा यू नो कमा के जाएं ताकि पूरा विश्व आपको सलाम करे आज अरुण हमारे साथ में नहीं है अब देख लीजिए लगभग 50 साल हो गए ये 71 का वाक्य है जिसमें हम बात कर रहे हैं टुडे वी आर सिटिंग इन 2020 ऑलमोस्ट 50 इयर्स बट येट व्हाई आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट अरुण
बिकॉज़ ऑफ हिज लेगेसी
सो व्हाई शुड ईच ऑफ यू आर ऑल अरुण्स आर ऑल यंग आई मीन अरुण आल्सो वर्क He gave up his life for something that he believed in. What is your life worth? So for heaven's sake, do what you think you are here to do and leave a legacy for yourself, for your family, for the country, for the society. That is my message to you. We'll all be dead and gone. But Arun is still Arun, no?
Yes, sir. Forever in our hearts. Forever.
So you are all as good as Arun. You're all Aruns. So go and be Arun. Make your life. Make a contribution.
Well said. Thank you so much, sir. I think that's very inspiring. something for all of us to think about and try and aspire to be. Next, sir, there are a few people who have made some sketches and portraits which we would like to share with you. So I'll just share. We have Akhil with us, who has made this beautiful sketch.
Oh my God.
That's awesome.
That is a really nice sketch.
Akhil, unmute kariye apne aapko. I think he has got the sketch also, must be having it with him. I think he'll show it to all of us.
Okay.
There he is. One second, I'll highlight the video.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Bachi. You must send me a WhatsApp of that. Keep that. It's a lovely sketch. Well done.
Akhil, abhi apne aap ko bhi dikha do.
Tumhara bhi chair Arun se milta hai. Thank you, bache. Bahut badhiya. That's really a nice sketch.
Next, we have two more.
WhatsApp zarur bhej do. Iske ek pic leke, huh?
We will send it to you, sir, for sure. Then we have Tisha Dhal, who has not been able to join us today, but she has she had made this and she wanted to share this with everyone in the session. So this has been made by Tisha. And we have another one which has been made by Savita.
Okay.
So this also. Savita, are you there?
What a beautiful, a lot of talented young people.
And sir, I wanted to dedicate a song to Arun sir. That's why I was asking you in the morning. So since you gave "Ae Mere Watan Ke Logo," I'll just sing a few lines as a dedication to Arun sir. Par mat bhoolo seema pe veeron ne jaan gawai. कुछ याद उन्हें भी कर लो, कुछ याद उन्हें भी कर लो, जो लौट के घर ना आए, जो लौट के घर ना आए. ऐ मेरे वतन के लोगों, जरा आँख में भर लो पानी, जो शहीद हुए हैं उनकी, जरा याद करो कुर्बानी, तुम भूल न जाओ उनको, इसलिए सुनो ये कहानी. जो शहीद हुए हैं उनकी, जरा याद करो कुर्बानी. थैंक यू.
आपने वाकई आंख में पानी भर दिया.
थैंक यू सर.
ब्यूटीफुल ब्यूटीफुल
सर. देयर वर सो मेनी अदर पीपल आल्सो हु वांटेड टू यू नो टॉक टू यू एंड गेट दिस, बट आई थिंक वी हैव हैड अ ब्यूटीफुल सेशन. ऑल ऑफ अस हैव एंजॉयड इट सो मच. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर टेकिंग आउट टाइम विद अस एंड शेयरिंग दीज ब्यूटीफुल स्टोरीज. आई थिंक इट्स अ मेमोरेबल टाइम, इट्स बीन अ मेमोरेबल मॉर्निंग फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. एंड मैम, आईड लाइक टू हैंड इट ओवर टू यू सो दैट यू कैन. थैंक यू श्रियंका, ब्यूटीफुल सॉन्ग. एंड मिस्टर खेत्रपाल, थैंक यू वंस अगेन for your time.
Thank you, Rajan. Thank you so much.
Amazing storyteller. You just bring those incidents come alive in front of our eyes. Thank you for your time. And I'd also like to thank our compares, Shriyank and Lalit, for all the effort they put into this. All of you for joining us. All the 70, we've got 70. We were expecting 67. We've got some more people. So 70 people who joined us on this Sunday morning. And also Madhuri, who's our, you know, she is the one who gets all the meetings done for us. Mr. Khetirpal, Madhuri, hi. Madhuri, say hello.
Congratulations.
Khetirpal, she sets up for us. From Pune. And also I'd like to thank Harsha and Palash. They are Symbiosis students, Symbiosis College Pune students. They made the video, Mr. Khetirpal. I hope you liked it.
Wow.
We'll send it first to you.
Wonderful.
Sir. We'll send that,
that'll really be nice. Please do share.
We'll do
I look forward to receiving. Thank you so much.
beautiful picture.
Thank you, Rajna.
All of these guys made. Those were amazing, I thought. Beautiful. Mm. So I will conclude the session now. Mr. Khetrapal, thank you so much. And thank you all of you for joining us.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Jai Hind. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Jai Hind, sir.
Jai Hind, sir.